Emotional Eating and Overeating. Learn how to stop binge eating disorder and compulsive overeating by developing a healthy relationship with food and quick excess weight loss through Mindfulness Eating Solution by Manuel Nestor Eagle. Narrated by Kenzy S. Taha. Introduction. Emotional eating involves consuming for reasons other than hunger. You can eat for being sad, upset, stressed, or lonely, or you could be using food as a reward. Food will render you relaxing and divert you from what does bother you. When you're an emotional eater, you may not hear the normal signs of hunger and fullness in your body. You should eat more than you need or wish for. Emotional eating can interfere with making healthy choices about food, and it can prevent you from getting to and remaining at a good weight. Emotional eating does not constitute a bona fide eating disorder. In any medical manual, at least, this is not a formal diagnosis. This is not yet as well known as nervous anorexia, bulimia, nervosa, or binge eating disorders. Nonetheless, several experienced physicians and reputable eating disorder services have observed individuals with unhealthy food ties. Emotional eating as a way to deal with feelings or problems in life may be part of another psychological condition. Depression, bulimia, binge eating disorder, and several anxiety disorders are also commonly associated with this. This can also be a way of dealing with pressures of daily life. As parents or as young people, the purpose of paying attention to emotional eating is to avoid this behavior from being a habit. It's the kind of thing that's addictive and repetitive, and although it's aimed at soothing and calming us, it usually fails. And it can take on an individual personality. We use food in hopes of offering warmth, however, paradoxically, it just creates more tension. What are the symptoms of emotional eating? Everybody eats for reasons other than hunger from time to time. But if you find that out of boredom or for the warmth you sometimes search for food, you may be eating for emotional reasons. Common signs of emotional eating are: you are changing your eating habits when you face greater tension in your life. Eat if you're not hungry or are full. I am eating to prevent a negative situation. Eat to cool your feelings. Food used as a reward. That was such a hard job or assignment argument. For example, I need some ice cream, candy, popcorn. Emotional eating comes not from hunger, but an overwhelming, urgent sensation or feeding desire. This usually comes on with the conscious or unconscious intent unexpectedly to help calm us down. While eating normally is fun, emotional eating is not. It's like eating a bag of chips and not paying attention to emptying the bowl. As the commercial puts it, "Bet you can't eat just one." As they're easy to get down, carbohydrates are also most widely used. They prove to be calming and satisfying. Who doesn't love having chips or cupcakes or donuts or cookies to wolf down? Chapter 1. Emotional Eating. There are several kinds of emotional eaters. Some eat in response to a negative emotion, while others eat in response to a positive emotion. Here are 12 examples of emotional eating. 1. When you're nervous, you snack. If you have to do stuff, work, studies, or exams, you subconsciously reach out for food. Especially when you're up late at night all by yourself, even though it can happen in the daytime and even in front of others. 2. You eat as an emotional response. You eat when you feel sad, annoyed, deception, angry, lonely, empty, anxious, tired, or boring. This is such a subconsciously rooted reaction that you don't even think about it. Whenever you feel those feelings, you only instinctively reach out for food. 3. You seek comfort in food. You try comfort food when you are feeling down. And though they are pure garbage and have zero nutritional value, you drown yourself in foods like rice, cream, cake, chocolate, and cookies. They are supplying you with warmth for some reason you can't quite understand. 4. You have difficulties losing weight because of the way you eat. But if you want to lose weight and know the methods behind weight loss, such as the ingredients and amounts you can eat, you have difficulty sticking with your diet. You can't seem to stop eating as and when you like. See next sign. 5. Your diet is out of balance. You can't stop eating. You eat even when you're not hungry, and even though you should have stopped a long time ago, you start eating. Your eating compulsion appears to have taken over your life. Often you'd even go out of your way just to get food or fulfill a certain craving, even though you might not be hungry at all. 6. You're eating and you feel good. You are emotionally dependent on food, and you rely on it for happiness. You gain positive emotions from feeding because it's nothing more than a benevolent practice to help you live, just like breathing, drinking water, and passing waste. And this is different from loving food while eating it, which is what I'm all about. This is explicitly about eating to extract the feeling of happiness, which creates unbalanced relationship. 7. If you feel good, you eat. You see, eating is a necessary companion for positive emotions, just as people are eating to celebrate good news. 8. Fascinated with cooking or chewing. You need fresh food. You enjoy eating. You can't help but think about the food when you're not eating. You are waiting for it and hoping for it. It's like you're in Wonderland when you're eating. Cooking and eating pulls from you an extreme degree of interest. Interestingly, neither food nor cooking reciprocate any of your curiosity. 9. You use emotionally charged terms to describe food or eating, such as sinful, decadent, guilt-ridden, heart, lust, indulgent, enticing, craving, tempting, etc. Even though food is a non-living object unable to feel or to return your love or hate. 10. Even if you're full, you snack. No matter how much you eat, you never feel quite satisfied, no matter how full you feel. Any pleasure you get from eating is momentary, and after a while, you go back to eating to regain the feeling. 11. Even though you're full, you think you're starving. Just after you had your fill, you keep thinking about food. Even after you're done eating, you think about what to do for the next meal. You're obsessed with XYZ food and eating it when you can. You can't wait until it's time to have dinner again. Once you get to eat, you think about how happy you'll be. You count down.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.